As a child, I had a dream.
Life.
Power.
Recognition.
Prestige.
The quest for destiny.
To one day be champion.
One day be champion.
To one day be champion.
Desire.
As a man, I have a dream.
Ambition.
I will be champion.
A hunger still unsatisfied.
I will not fail.
I cannot fail.
The yearning.
Unleash the demon inside.
Sacrifice the soul for the coveted goal.
Whatever means necessary.
The light is brighter.
Whatever it takes.
The taste sweeter.
Whatever means necessary.
Sacrifice. Whatever it takes.
Destiny.
Whatever means necessary.
Whatever it takes.
The dream.
Whatever means necessary.
Pain. Sacrifice.
Agony.
I will be champion.
Whatever it takes.
Ticking towards Survivor Series Deadly Game tonight on pay-per-view. 13 big matches in the Deadly Game tournament. Who will be champion? And you see the clock on your screen, 54 minutes away. And Jim Cornette, what about the big triple threat match to determine the Tag Team Champions.
Oh! Well, you see one of the former WWF Tag Team Championship combos, the LOD, in the ring. The triple threat match tonight will feature the Headbangers taking on D'Lo Brown and Mark Henry, taking on the New Age Outlaws. And remember, because of the triple threat rules, the Outlaws do not have to lose the match to lose the title.
And here comes Draws now. He calls himself the first string member of the Legion of Doom, and he misses with the elbow. And can Holly now take advantage?
He got so high in the air that Holly had room to get out from under him.
Inverted atomic drop now, and here's Holly with a big old clothesline, and he knocks Draws down. Jim, this big tournament for the Deadly Game, 13 big matches in the first round, 10-minute time limits, which means the action is going to be hot and heavy.
That's right. The tournament rules favor an offensive approach tonight in the Deadly Game because in addition to the 10-minute time... Wait.
Here's a cover now and a kick out.
Almost had him. In addition to the 10-minute time limits in the first round, you must win to advance.
And here we go now. Holly and Draws Harriman away. An animal in there against Scorpio as well. All four men in the ring. Folks, the Deadly Game Tournament, Mr. McMahon guarantees there will be a new WWF champion tonight. And we can guarantee you're going to see it all on pay-per-view.
That's right. The WWF world knows how to tell time. And Scorpio just got, I don't think he knows his own name. He got turned upside down. And it looks like now the LOD setting up for the Doomsday Device.
And here's Draws now off the top rope. And he hits Scorpio with a big old clothesline. And the Legion of Doom should be able to put this one away. Scorpio's in trouble.
But
look at it from behind.
Holly from out of nowhere gave a knee to Animal's back, and they're both out on the floor. Look, there's Al Snow.
Al Snow used head on Draws, and here's the cover by Scorpio. And it's over. The Job Squad with a huge upset over the Legion of Doom.
Scorpio.
Well, Draws, the recipient of a little headshot there, courtesy of Al Snow. Kept their eye on.
So Draws delivering the Doomsday Device. It looked like it was all over. Bob Holly came out of nowhere to make the save. And I'll tell you what, folks, what a way to kick off Sunday Night Heat. Hello again, everybody. Michael Cole, Jim Cornette at ringside as we get ready for Survivor Series Deadly Game, including the big WWF Women's Championship on the line. Sable against Jacqueline.
Been waiting a long time for this. Sable's been in hard training, but she's going to have her hands full because she gives up experience to Jacqueline.
How about the Lethal Weapon Steve Blackman in action against Gangrel?
And Gangrel will have the Brutal on ringside with him, so Blackman's going to have his hands full.
And we've told you about this all weekend long. Mr. McMahon plans to confront The Rock right here tonight, live on Sunday Night Heat. What is going to happen?
And what can McMahon possibly do that he hasn't already done to The Rock right here on the eve of the Deadly Game?
And how about 13 big matches to determine the new WWF champion? Which one of these men is going to win the WWF championship?
Well, Vince McMahon has tailored this tournament to suit his own needs, but there may be some problems in his path.
We are at the sold-out kill.
Can I get ready?
Right now.
Mr. McMahon, it's you.
The Stooges, well, they said Mr. McMahon wants to see Stone Cold.
He wants to see more than just The Rock tonight.
You gotta hear Bob.
On Sunday Night Heat, and here comes Tiger Ali Singh, set for singles action. But I can't believe what we just saw. The associates of Mr. McMahon telling Stone Cold Steve Austin that the boss wants to see him tonight as well. So I guess he's going to confront The Rock and Stone Cold.
And I'm just wondering, Mr. Twister, if it'll be both at the same time.
Ali Singh.
Folks, we are just minutes away from Survivor Series Deadly Game, the huge tournament to crown a new WWF champion. It has been 2 months since we've had a WWF champion, unprecedented in the history of the World Wrestling Federation.
And I'll tell you this, St. Louis has been jacked and ready for this thing. The WWF has taken over St. Louis this weekend. The superstars have been everywhere, and these people tonight are ready to see a new WWF champion. And what's Tiger?
Hello.
Oh, gee.
Here we go.
Asian royalty.
Well, thank goodness. Thank you, Val. He never fights. He always talks.
Over 21,000 people jam-packed in the Kiel Center greeting Val Venus. And folks, last week on Raw, Terry Runnels accompanied Val Venus to ringside, but Val sent her away. But Terry, a woman scorned, returned with her revenge.
Well, you don't dump Terry Runnels even if she tries to stick you with a baby that's not yours. We've heard rumors that Terry Runnels can be a little on the vindictive side, and I believe this gave credence to some of them.
Well, Tiger Ali Singh doesn't like it too much. Val just took the microphone from him, but I think this crowd would rather hear from Val.
I'd rather hear a
hello, ladies.
We'll talk about that later.
So this is St. Louis. Home of the Budweiser. Well, you know something, the Big Balboski is not too much of a beer drinker. However, he will always make an exception when it comes to a little Anheuser-Busch.
Wow. And here's Tiger now, misses with the right hand, and we're underway. And my question is, Val Venus saying last week that he couldn't be the father of Terry Runnels. Baby, well, who would be the father of Terry Runnels' baby now if it's not Val?
Well, that's a very good question for which we don't have a good answer. All we know is that Val has had the unkindest cut of all, as the king said, and he could possibly be the father. Who that narrows it down to, frankly, I don't know, and I'm not sure I need that much information.
So Tiger Ali Singh now in control, folks, and the action continues to heat up tonight on USA. Next, Bobby's new girl is a member of the world's oldest profession, Ride with the Pack on Pacific Blue.
And then at 9, Tom and Cassie head behind the Iron Curtain to catch an undercover agent on silk stockings. Hey, Michael, what's the best bait for undercover agents anyway?
Hey, I'll tell you what, at 10 o'clock, Nikita must protect a fellow agent in danger of losing her unborn baby. PETA Wilson is La Femme Nikita. Stay right there. Sunday Night Heat continues right here on USA. Oh, and Tiger Ali Singh in control. Folks, of course, the big tournament, Deadly Game Tournament, to crown a new WWF champion. Someone's going to have to win 4 matches tonight to be crowned champion, unless you're The Undertaker or Kane. They have a bye in the first round. They will meet in the quarterfinals. Mr. McMahon hoping that they will annihilate each other so neither one makes it to the final round.
Very good point. That match was arranged to take place by Mr. McMahon so they can eliminate each other. And Kane is going to be on the opposite side of his father, Paul Bearer, for the first time in his life. Kane's without guidance. He doesn't know right from wrong. And when you got a 7-foot monster that doesn't have a conscience on the loose, that is a deadly game.
You know, the first time we ever saw Kane was right here in the Kiel Center last October.
I remember that very well. He made a very auspicious debut. And I'll tell you one thing for Tiger Ali Singh. He's a smart wrestler because he attacks the part of the anatomy that he knows will cause the most pain. And Val Venus, he does all that talking about the Balboski. He leads his opponents right to it.
Now, the last time, Jim, that of course here in the Kiel Center, Kane made his appearance, and he cost The Undertaker dearly in that Hell in a Cell matchup.
And I'm sure that The Undertaker hasn't forgotten that, especially when he got in the arena today, and he had all those memories come flooding back. Undertaker!
It's the Godfather! The Godfather attacking Tiger from behind! The Godfather with a long-standing issue with Tiger Ali Singh! And now can Val take advantage?
They've had their problems, and now Godfather has thrown Tiger Ali Singh into the ropes!
Nice maneuver by Val! There's the bridge! The cover! It's over! Val Venus defeats Tiger Ali Singh, giving assist to the Godfather!
And suplex by Val Venus definitely hooked a big one right in the mouth.
Val Venus victorious, and Tiger Ali Singh a bit upset in the ring with Babu.
What's he upset at Babu for?
Folks, we are less than 45 minutes away from Survivor Series Deadly Game. And folks, coming up next, a look at the rocky road on the way to Survivor Series Deadly Game.
One man will reach his destination and the rest will come to a dead end tonight in the Deadly Game.
Sunday Night Heat comes to you live from beautiful downtown St. Louis, Busch Stadium, the home of the St. Louis Cardinals, and over 21,000 fans have jammed the Kiel Center for Sunday Night Heat and Survivor Series. And folks, tonight Heat is brought to you by Very Bad Things by PolyGram Film. This Thanksgiving, Christian Slater and Cameron Diaz have been bad, very bad.
and by foot action. For every action, there's foot action.
And by Skittles bite-sized candies, taste the rainbow of fruit flavors.
And by WWF The Music Volume 2, experience your favorite WWF original jams on sale now at all Sam Goody and Musicland stores and other fine retailers.
We are minutes away from Survivor Series Deadly Game, the tournament to crown a new WWF champion.
We have no World Wrestling Federation champion as we speak.
So Mr. McMahon set up a deadly single elimination tournament for Survivor Series and personally guaranteed a new WWF champion.
What a deadly game that's gonna be.
And in this deadly tournament, there are favorites.
Since I have a problem with the people,
I have a problem with the people's champion.
When McMahon hurts The Rock, he hurts the people.
McMahon just screwed The Rock out of any opportunity to be the WWF champion.
You're the people's chump.
When McMahon hurts The Rock, he hurts the people.
You're not gonna have a job
if you don't beat Mark Henry.
The Rock is fighting for his life.
You're nothing but the people's ass.
The Rock says he would much rather be the people's ass than to ever kiss yours.
McMahon hits the people how he likes, the people's elbow. Oh! Yes! The Rock is in the Survivor Series for the WWF title.
There has been a reconciliation.
The Undertaker back on the dark side with Paul Bearer.
Those of you who do not declare shall be declared.
Paul Bearer just hit his own stomach.
Kane!
You're stupid!
You're
stupid! You can't even speak for yourself!
Both Paul Bearer and The Undertaker have turned their back on Kane. He is a ship without a rudder.
I used you, boy!
He only knows one thing, and that's destruction! To do it!
On the next pay-per-view, you two are gonna battle it out.
The Undertaker on a collision course with his younger brother Kane at the Survivor Series.
You're gonna have to fight for it.
You never cared about me.
I couldn't do anything right for you. I am no longer your boy, Dad.
In some respects, I think I lost a son tonight, but maybe I gained another.
Vince, you know, he's like a big, cuddly teddy bear.
This is the WWF Hardcore Championship belt, and Mick, you earned it.
Champion.
And I still would love to know why everybody has an opponent but Mankind. It's a mystery, opponent.
Gee, thanks, Dad.
Stone Cold, screw you! You're fired!
He did it!
You think you own everybody? Look at you! You're pathetic! On your knees, crying in front of the world.
I hate Stone Cold! I don't listen to you anymore.
It was me, Dad, that hired Stone Cold back. It was me!
I guess I finally have your attention now, don't I?
Stone Cold!
It won't be the day after a Survivor Series that you get your title shot. It'll be at the Survivor Series.
Survivor Series at Deadly Games. Me and you, we gonna play. But you're gonna play.
You're gonna play.
If you've got a plan for Stone Cold Steve Austin,
then should you make it all the way to the final championship match,
you would have wrestled some four times.
You can bet your sorry ass it's gonna backfire.
I hate Stone Cold.
Can Stone Cold Steve Austin become the next WWF champion? A lot of people will say, hell yes to that.
Men will become WWF champion. 13 matches, and Mr. McMahon guarantees a new champ will be crowned. And look at some of these matches.
Well, some of these men have an easier path to the finals than others, but it's not going to be easy for anybody. Only one man can win the prize. The rest are going to lose the Deadly Game.
The Deadly Game just minutes away. Survivor Series from the sold-out Kiel Center in St. Louis, and then you see The Rock. That is a live shot in his dressing room. Folks, when we come back,
People's Champion awaits his sentence.
Hey, Shane, get out of here. Mr. McMahon won't see you in the ring. Get out of here.
Your father wants you.
Your dad wants you.
Your dad wants you. Come on.
Mr. McMahon wants you in the ring, boy.
What? Now the associates are summoning Shane, so Mr. McMahon wants to see The Rock, Stone Cold, and Shane. What in the world's going on?
Vince McMahon is gathering all the people who have been trouble for him recently. But why? This can't be good.
And here comes the DOA, set for tag team action. Survivor Series just minutes away, the big triple threat match for the WWF Tag Team Championship. The Outlaws versus the Headbangers versus Mark Henry and D'Lo Brown.
We could see a new WWF champion, new tag team champion, a new women's champion, all in one night tonight at the Survivor Series. And what a great historic wrestling city St. Louis is for all that gold to be on the line.
So 8-Ball and Skull, along with Mr. .com, Paul Ellering, set for action. Look out! That's Bradshaw and Farouk!
Farouk and Bradshaw, look out! Coming
out
of the way! Give that Big Texan plenty of room!
Bradshaw is hammered away with a chair, and Farouk on the other side has stairs!
He was swinging that big metal folding chair like a lumberjack swings an axe, and he just chopped Skull down, and Farouk with the steps on 8-Ball!
And now Ellering. And he's going to be double-teamed in the ring. What is going on? Bradshaw and Farouk together?
Farouk and they're wearing matching tights. They've got some kind of symbols painted on their chest that match.
Oh!
And a double powerbomb to Paul Ellering. And the
Farouk and Bradshaw together? What the hell is going on?
I was going to say heck, but I still don't know either, Michael. These guys have just come out here and laid the DOA and Paul Ellering out.
Bradshaw and Farouk together. All hell is breaking loose out here. Let's go back to Kevin Kelly.
There's going to be a lot more hell breaking loose tonight in the tag team title triple threat match. The New Age Outlaws defending. But gentlemen, you got to be a little upset. I mean, you don't even have to get pinned in order to lose those belts.
It's not fair. It's not fair, Vinny. You see, Vinny Mac, I guess you and your horde of storybook writers think that I'm Erica Kane and he's Tad Martin. Well, you keep setting them up. We'll keep knocking them down. You see, DX tonight is staking its claim right here at the Kiel Center in St. Louis, Missouri. Billy, tattoo it. You see, it's starting right here, and it ain't ending.
What is going? Michael, they're the Headbangers.
They've been attacked by the Headbangers.
And there's Mark Henry and D'Lo Brown.
These are the three teams that are going to fight it out for the tag team title tonight in a triple threat match at the Survivor Series, but they couldn't wait.
The Headbangers ambushing the New Age Outlaws and Mark Henry and D'Lo Brown now.
They've gone past, they've gone past the locker room area into the hallway in the bowels of the Kiel Center, and they are taking it to one another.
Comes to you live from the sold-out Kiel Center Survivor Series minutes away in the big WWF Women's Championship. Jacqueline versus Sable. And it all began 2 months ago, Jim, when Jacqueline won the championship over Sable on Raw.
Well, that's right. There had been a challenge made and accepted, and Sable was cooking. Even Mark Merrow felt the sting of Sable's wrath, but as she had Jacqueline in hand, a little helpful hand from Merrow and a little leverage sealed the deal.
And then last month, the ultimate humiliation. Jacqueline, with a pair of scissors, cut Sable's hair.
And Jacqueline later was to weave that into her own hair as a trophy of sorts, a psychological stimulation, and that has led to what we will see tonight with the women's gold on the line.
That's what it's all about tonight, the WWF Women's Championship. Jacqueline defends against Sable. Championship on the line.
Well, she may be the fan favorite, but she's also the underdog. She doesn't have near the experience of Jacqueline. And bear in mind, Jacqueline trained to wrestle with men. She's as tough as they come. When she was training, when she was breaking into the sport of wrestling, she had to train with men. There were no women around for her to train with.
And that's a good point, Jim Cornette. Sable needs a magnificent performance tonight to defeat Jacqueline.
Sable, tonight's the night.
Survivor Series Deadly Game, everyone is going to be watching when you go for the gold against the WWF Women's Champion, Jacqueline.
Well, Kevin, with all the guarantees that are floating around the WWF, I'd like to add one of my own. I guarantee that tonight, I will become the new WWF Women's Champ.
So now we have three guarantees.
Well, certainly I know you've put a lot of time into your preparation.
Wait a minute.
Hard work.
Oh, come on. Look down the aisle.
Now, what is he doing out here? He has no business at all being out here.
Guys,
this is ridiculous.
Well, it's going to be up to Kevin Kelly to keep this thing
separate.
What do
we owe your honor?
Nobody knows you as good as I do.
That's for
sure. I'm out here out of the goodness of my heart to give you a chance.
What?
You see, tonight, Jacqueline is going to hurt you, Sable. You're no wrestler. You never will be a wrestler. And if you were smart, you would just say no.
Hey! Jacqueline! From behind!
I was paying attention to Mero. I never even saw her coming.
Jacqueline came from somewhere. She just clocked Sable with the Women's Championship.
Jacqueline trying to make Sable mad. Make her nervous. Make her make a rookie mistake. Jackie is playing a deadly mind game.
So Miro cost Sable the WWF Women's Championship a couple of months ago. And tonight, he's cost Sable again.
The old misdirection play, Michael.
Sable may be hurt. We're back on Sunday Night Heat. Just moments ago, a vicious sneak attack on Sable. A hit and run from Jacqueline to send perhaps Sable a message.
Well, we were all had our attention on Mark Mero when Jacqueline came out of nowhere, out of the crowd, with that championship belt, the women's title belt, and just blasted Sable from behind. I don't know whether it was to injure or to just send a psychological message.
And now this is a live shot in the dressing room area.
No.
Medical personnel officials attending to Sable. Apparently, she'll be ready to go tonight for the WWF Women's Championship against Jacqueline. It's minutes away. Survivor Series deadly game. And here comes the lethal weapon, Steve Blackman. And I'll tell you what, Jim, Steve Blackman with a lot on his mind as of late. It began a few weeks ago, but 2 weeks ago on Raw, Blackman was in action when he was attacked by Owen Hart. Then it all continued backstage. Blackman finally got his hands on Owen Hart, but look who came from out of nowhere.
Well, we had all thought that Owen Hart was the Blue Blazer, but there they are, the same place at the same time.
And then again last Monday night, Owen Hart and the Blue Blazer double-teaming Blackman again. I want to know what's going on. I mean, we all thought the Blue Blazer was Owen Hart. Obviously, that isn't the case. So Steve Blackman set for action. And he's gonna have his hands full tonight on Heat.
Oh, what a sight.
I dare say they're the most unique group in the WWF today. Gangrel in the middle, Edge to his left, Christian to his right. And folks, last week on Raw, it was Kane versus Edge. When Kane systematically picked apart the Brood one by one. Gangrel, Edge, and Christian going for the ride, and then Kane attempted the most heinous of acts.
Well, a can of gasoline and a blowtorch could have spelled disaster for a monster who doesn't know right from wrong, but fortunately, the officials were there. But here you see the Brood, in my mind, one of the hottest young groups in the WWF. These guys, I have a problem that neither Gangrel nor Edge were selected for the Deadly Game tournament. I have a problem with that.
So it's Gangrel versus Steve Blackman, the lethal weapon. Folks, still to come tonight on Sunday Night Heat, Mr. McMahon has summoned The Rock, Stone Cold Steve Austin, and here we go now, and his own son, Shane McMahon, to the ring for a confrontation.
You know, we have seen so many things just tonight in Heat, and now looking at Gangrel and the Brood and their entrance, they ought to rename the WWF. This isn't the World Wrestling Federation, it's the Extreme
extremely strange wrestling federation, and they're getting weirder and wilder by the minute.
We're just minutes away from the Survivor Series Deadly Game Tournament on pay-per-view. 13 big matches to determine a new WWF champion. I'll tell you what, Mankind in the first round with a mystery opponent. And my question to you is this. Is Mankind being groomed to be the WWF corporate champion?
Well, for months now, Vince McMahon has made no secret that he wants a corporate champion, a suit and tie guy, a guy he can take to meetings and lunches and power lunches and all those type of things.
Here's a cover now by Gangrel Blackman with a kick out.
Austin wasn't the man. The Rock made no bones about that he's not the man. Maybe McMahon figures Mankind is the man.
Survivor Series Deadly Game. Here's a cover again by Gangrel and a kick out live on pay-per-view. All you got to do is call your local cable company or home satellite provider to subscribe. We're minutes away, folks. I can't wait. 13 big matches. It's been 2 months since we've had a WWF champion. Mr. McMahon guarantees there will be one crowned tonight.
And I don't remember any pay-per-view event or any kind of event in my history in this industry that you could absolutely guarantee a new champion would be crowned. And I'll tell you something else. I don't know what's on Vince McMahon's mind, but I see that the clock is ticking and in heat. Before this program is over with, Vince McMahon will have the three thorns in his side in this ring.
Just about 14 minutes away from Survivor Series. The first round matches in that tournament go 10 minutes. It is going to be a test. It's going to be fast-paced. Here's a cover by Gangrel, and again, a kick out by Blackman. But
much like this match has been, these guys have been going to get it from the opening bell, and that's what you're going to have to do. You have to win to advance in the Deadly Game, and the short time limits are going to indicate a very offensive approach.
I'll tell you what, my dark horse in the tournament, Ken Shamrock, the Intercontinental Champion. Shamrock, just last month, here's a cover again by Gangrel and another kick out. Shamrock, just last month, won a one-night tournament to win the Intercontinental Championship. He has the experience in this type of event. He has the endurance. He has the necessary skill to get the job done.
Going back to no-holds-barred competition, the ultimate fighting situation, Shamrock is tournament-tested in all types of combat sports. But with this field and the way that things have been arranged by Vince McMahon, there's no telling what's going to happen.
And I want to know what's going to happen if Mankind and Mr. McMahon's security guard, the Big Boss Man, advance to the tournament. What's going to happen if Mankind has to face the Big Boss Man?
Well, you've seen how Mr. McMahon rewards loyalty. That's all I'm going to say about that. But look at Blackman with the belly-to-belly. Steve Blackman is taking it to Gangrel. And Gangrel is at this point, I can't tell whether he's, that's the stuff he drinks or whether he's got his mouth busted open.
And there's Christian now on the apron and Edge now on the top rope. The referee is distracted. Edge from behind. What a drop kick to the back of the head. And now Gangrel, a pit bull. Can he take advantage here? And, wow. He just planted Blackman. Gangrel with the cover. And it's over. Gangrel. And look at this. Look out. Christian's climbing the rope. And Blackman explodes. And Christian with a headbutt to the sternum.
Boy, the brood. They get on an opponent like a pack of wild dogs or like sharks when they smell blood in the water. No pun intended, Michael. And Gangrel comes out with a victory. Give the assist to the members of the brood. But these three men are going to be a force to be reckoned with. Three of the finest young superstars in the WWF ring.
Gangrel picks up the victory. Give the assist to Edge. Christian had a little spice there at the end. I'll tell you what, the brood ready to rock and roll on the World Wrestling Federation. It's Steve Blackman trying to regain his composure and his thoughts in the ring. Tell you what, I don't think Blackman knew what hit him.
Well, once again, I have a problem with Gangrel and Edge not being in the Deadly Game Tournament, but I have a problem with Blackman not being
in the... Hey, it's a blazer! It's a blue blazer!
The blue blazer descending from the ceiling.
What in the world? And Blackman, he's still in la-la land. I don't even think, and now he sees him.
Blackman's gonna be in trouble if he doesn't come. Wait a minute, the blazer.
The blazer's hit some turbulence.
Well, he's looks like he's stuck in that harness.
He can't get out.
He's stuck. The idiot is stuck in the harness.
The blazer was dropping in, but he got a little hung up.
Didn't he think about that beforehand?
I think the blazer didn't get clearance from the air traffic controller, a human pinata.
I think the same guy planned Blazer's attack as planned General Custer's attack on the Indians.
I think Blackman's going to knock him until the candy comes out. Look at this.
Well, he's just a sitting duck. He can't. He's caught in his cape. In his harness.
Now he's going back up. Well, what type of a fool comes down and can't get out of the harness?
I'm begging somebody to crank him up as quick as you can.
is nonsense. Unreal. Blackman, this is ridiculous.
Hey, wait a minute. What's this?
Rock, jabroni.
Come on, hold on. I'll tell you what, the people's champ will come out when he's ready. You three jabronis, what you want to do? You go right up to People's Hall, hang that left right there. There's a big box of Dunkin' Donuts for you three Rudy Poo.
Get in the ring now. He wants you all now. Come on.
And there you see him, the owner of the World Wrestling Federation, Mr. McMahon, who personally guarantees the new champion tonight.
I promised you that tonight you will see a WWF champion crown.
He's been right on every guarantee thus far.
I would also like to promise you, no, I would like to guarantee that this will be a Survivor Series you will never, ever forget. I guarantee it. Right now, I want to get something off my chest. And I want to start with the people's chump, the people's ass.
Uh-oh.
I want to start with The Rock.
Oh, here, look out. We've been waiting for
you
it.
You smell what The Rock is cooking.
People's champ, 21,000 plus in the Kiel Center. On their feet, it folks, Nestle Crunch presents the 1998 Survivor Series, a deadly game. It is next only on pay-per-view. Nestle Crunch, it's just more fun to munch.
Well, the Stooges have Mr. McMahon surrounded along
the
with
associates.
The yeah, along with the big boss man as protection.
And now, I want to get something off my chest as well and bring somebody else out here. My own flesh and blood, my son, Shane McMahon.
Yeah, his own flesh and blood. He's going to love this.
Well, Shane McMahon showed a lot of guts finally standing up to his dad, but at what price?
Yeah,
to the McMahon family, to the whole family.
From a corporate officer, Jim, to a lowly referee. That's what Mr. McMahon did to his son, Shane.
Yeah, well, bear in mind, Shane gave him some provocation, but hey, he finally stood up to the old man, and a lot of people appreciated that.
You got to give Shane credit. He's been doing a great job as referee here in recent weeks. He's always got a smile on his face. You got to give him credit. He's
and
not letting
get
him down.
To vent my spleen on Stone Cold Steve Austin.
Hold on to your seats, folks. This place is fixing to blow.
The man, Mr. McMahon, says he hates the Rattlesnake, Stone Cold Steve Austin. Will he be the next WWF champion tonight at Survivor Series?
He's the man that many feel should still be the WWF.
WWF Championship.
I'm talking to the three of you. I'm talking to you.
Well, they won't take their eyes off each other.
This may come as a shock. Yeah, I'm talking to you.
What in the world?
Wait a minute. He wasn't invited to the party.
I don't think Mr. McMahon wanted to confront him.
We've got a blockout in St. Louis.
No! Oh! Paul Bearer, the Phenom, who has returned to the dark side, is the Undertaker looking for Austin. Does the Undertaker still blame Stone Cold Steve Austin for costing him the championship at Judgment Day?
You know darn good and well he does. Steve Austin blames the Undertaker. Blame Steve Austin. They
Series.
Any one of these superstars could become WWF Champion. Shamrock and Goldust, Alsto and Mankind, the Big Boss Man with The Undertaker.
They're not just in the ring, they're all over the building. The Rock and Austin have gone to the back, and Undertaker, they're in the back of the arena.
You see the Associates, Briscoe, Patterson, Slaughter, Mr. McMahon, all in ringside. They want these men to hammer at each other.
The Boss Man is staying on The Undertaker, and hey!
Oh my God. Wait a minute! Not in the world! What in the world? Look at The Undertaker staring at his brother. Kane, The Undertaker, will collide in the quarterfinals. The Undertaker alone in the ring. Here comes Kane.
Kane will meet his brother. And if history is any judge or any indication, it will be unearthly. It will be hell on earth for one of these two men tonight at the Survivor Series.
The Undertaker said Kane couldn't handle the dark side, that he was weak. Folks, Survivor Series, what a deadly game it's going to be!